Story 1. Indiana Experience. There's this graveyard in this town that I visited once with a group of friends. We love taking road trips, and we do so whenever we get the chance. We scour the internet for interesting places, and then off we go. This graveyard is off the highway and down a gravel road. It's a beautiful cemetery. Although the feelings I felt, that the occupants weren't exactly happy with us being there, but in general, they were at peace. The trail, located at the end of the gravel road, seemed eerily dark. If you turned off your light, you couldn't see your hand in front of you. Though it was warm out that night, I was inexplicably cold. I don't normally get cold. The trail, I'm told, used to be the road, but the left side was a cliff, and pieces of it just kept breaking off and falling. So they closed it to save money. It's almost a mile long. It hadn't rained in a while, nor had there been any strong winds, but there was water everywhere and tree branches left and right on the trail that climbed upward at about a 45 degree angle. After a few minutes on the trail, we broke free of the water and branches. It was beautiful, but I couldn't escape that eerie feeling that kept tickling at the back of my neck. The trail is relatively smooth, just small cracks and crevices along the sides. So I was pretty surprised when my boyfriend got his foot caught in a small hole. He came close to breaking his ankle. At one point we came to a large tree branch. It still had green leaves that curtained the path in front of us, and we had to climb over it. We continued along the trail, and I swear, it was almost as if someone was throwing pebbles at us. We get to the top, and I notice that we now hear nature sounds. Crickets are chirping. There's a little brook at the bottom of the cliff that we can now hear. The sky is calm and clear. My constant chill is gone. I notice that there are two gravestones that almost look like beds, and I really want to go over and check them out. Beside them was a large black dog. It's strange because it was a well-lit area, but there was no light reflecting off the dog's eyes, making it seem like he almost had no eyes at all. I asked a friend about it, and he said it was probably just a caretaker's dog. Maybe the graveyard dog. I watched the dog as it guarded the graves, and then I looked down for just a moment to turn the flashlight off, and when I looked back up, the dog was gone. Story 2. The Railroad Bridge Experience. About 2.5 years ago, I went to a railroad bridge with two of my friends. One of them was my very best friend, who I would trust with my life. Neither one of them even hinted at there being a type of story about this bridge. Not even a happy ghost story, because things like this freak me out. I was 4 or 5 months pregnant at the time. Navigating the trail was not easy, because it was dark. And, well, I was pregnant. Along the way, I felt like someone was caressing my arm. This happened numerous times, but I didn't let on that I was scared. One thing that stands out of my mind is that one friend stopping and shining his light in a tree. Lying on the branch was something that looked like a dehydrated squirrel. It had a bushy tail, but dry eye sockets, scary looking teeth. At this point, I really don't want to stay, but the bridge is just ahead. Or so they said. It was too foggy to spot it in the dark. About 2 minutes later, the fog is absolutely gone, and the bridge is right in front of me, like it appeared out of nowhere. My male friend walked out across the bridge carefully. There's planks missing because this railroad track is no longer in use, and the bridge is no longer maintained. He came running back about a minute later, saying we had to leave immediately. He walked behind us, knife in one hand, flashlight sweeping the area in the other. Even pregnant and walking the trails, I was able to keep up with my female friend. When we made it to the clearing, I snuck a look back, and right off the side of the trail, hidden in the shrubs, was bright yellow eyes staring back at me. What was with us on the rail bridge that night? Story 3. the devil. On June 20th, 1996, at exactly 12 o'clock midnight, I had the most horrible experience happen to me. Although most people don't believe me, it happened. I work at a meat packer. I've been working there a couple months. I had second shift, 3 p.m. till 11:30 at night. On that night, a couple of friends and I were on our way home. We rode in a company van and dropped us off 3 blocks away from our home. Friends lived closer to the van's drop-off than I did, so I said my farewells and took off for home. As I walked, I distinctly remember looking down at my watch to see what time it was. It was only a couple minutes to midnight. As I walked, I knew my wife would be waiting for me. She was always waiting for me. As I was nearing my house, only 2 doors away, when a man dressed in black called to me. He was behind a tree. He asked if I had a cigarette, and me being a smoker, I said sure. I handed him one, and as my hand brushed against his, I felt a nullifying chill run down my spine. He asked for a light, and I pulled out my lighter and lit his cigarette. But as I did, I could see that all the light that came from this lighter was engulfed by total darkness. That was it for me. I was frightened, and I bid him good night. He then asked me what I was doing out so late at night. I quickly told him I was going home from work. He said, "Ah, that's good for you. Would not like to be doing anything else on this night, for you never know what's out there waiting for you." All right, sir. Thank you for the advice," I told him, "but I really must be going." I turned around to leave. Hastily, he called after me and called me by my real name. I turned around to see him, knowing all too well that I did not give him my name. And he said, "Truly, there are some sad times when a man has no fear for the devil." And then he laughed the most horrendous laughter I have ever heard. I ran as quickly as my legs could carry me. I turned to see him melting into thin air. When I got home, my wife asked if there was anything wrong because I looked so pale. I just couldn't answer at the moment. Later on, without me telling her anything, she asked me why I was standing there by the tree, talking to the tree. She said she looked out the window to see if I was almost home and saw me talking to myself standing at the tree. I told her there was a man there. I told her what he said to me, and she went pale. She had heard the same laughter, but thought it was just the drunk neighbors. I'll never forget that frightful night. And when I think of the words that the Prince of Darkness said to me, I will never forget it. Believe me or not, it happened. Thanks for listening. I hope you enjoyed the stories. If you did, hit that subscribe button and give me a thumbs up. I really do appreciate it. Bye.